This Week in Real Pirate Ball, documenting the 2011 Pittsburgh Pirates baseball season. And here's your host, Greg Mercer.
What's up, everybody? It's Mercer here with week number 3 of This Week in Real Pirate Ball. Let's go ahead and get into it right now. Just as it was in 2010, the early season has been highlighted by some great pitching performances by the Pirates starters. So far this season, free agent acquisition Kevin Correia has been as close to an ace as you could probably have. Correa is 3-1 with a 2.48 ERA and a minuscule .97 whip so far. He's even pitched a scoreless inning in relief so far this year. I must say, I'm pretty impressed with what Correa has done. He's been awful as a starter in the past, but you can see that he has great command of the strike zone and has used his sinker effectively to induce ground balls. Some people have pointed to the tragic loss of Kevin's brother as the reason for his disappointing 2010. Not sure I buy it completely, but in any event, he's in the zone right now. There's still a long way to go, and there's always a chance he could pull a Zach Duke from last year, but for now, people can't help but chant his name.
I'd like to tell you about an ex-Padre. You know, he mows down. He's about 6 feet four. From his hand to the mound. You know, comes out field just before twilight. He makes a real look good, Lord. I make him look so bright. And his name's
no one's surprise, shortstop Ronny Cedeno has once again stumbled at the plate to start the 2011 season. Going into Sunday's game, Cedeno was hitting 193 with a 445 OPS. Luckily for the Pirates, he's been okay in the field. He's right around league average in fielding percentage and actually ranks 4th in all of baseball among everyday shortstops in range factor. The problem with Cedeno is that it seems as though he's never learned from his previous mistakes. During a game last week, Cedeno slid headfirst into first base, something that new first base coach Luis Silverio claimed would never happen this year.
And never say never.
Also, Cedeno foolishly ran at third base with two outs in a tie game while Chris Snyder was lumbering home. He was almost thrown out at third, and had he been out, Snyder wouldn't have scored the winning run. Mistakes like these need to be eliminated if Cedeno hopes to stay in the starting lineup. Why do you say that, you ask? This week, the Pirates acquired shortstop Brandon Wood on waivers from the Angels.
He said Wood.
Wood was once thought to be a can't-miss minor league prospect and averaged over 20 homers a year and a near 900 OPS in the minors. Unfortunately, the jump to the majors has proved to be too much for Wood as he has a career 168 batting average. Pirates are hoping that a fresh start will somehow spark the innate talent the 25-year-old has.
Pizza Outlet, the taste that screams fresh.
Oh man, that was beautiful.
To claim Wood, the Pirates decided to waive struggling Rule 5 pick Josh Rodriguez, or J-Rod as he's been called. It's too bad the Pirates wasted the top Rule 5 pick to try to fill a hole instead of taking the best available talent, but hey, it wasn't all bad for J-Rod. According to sources on Twitter, Rodriguez got a chance to eat one last meal at Permane Brothers. I'm sure the coleslaw eased the burning pain of losing a Major League roster spot. It's not all good news for the Pirates starters so far this year. James McDonald, who showed a decent amount of promise in his limited starts last year, has pitched a lot more like Ronald McDonald in his first four starts.
The wacky adventures of a Ronald McDonald.
His 10.13 ERA and 198 whip are very reminiscent of what Charlie Morton did last year. McDonald's lack of control has caused him to bring his pitchers closer to the middle of the strike zone, and hitters haven't missed his mistakes. Let's hope that McDonald settles down as the season wears on. I'd hate for him to succumb to the curse of the Pirates' ace like so many other pitchers have before him. Let's take a quick look at some positive performances in the Pirates' minor league system. In AAA Indianapolis, starter Rudy Owens has looked strong in the early going, boasting a 2.95 ERA and 1.15 whip with 15 strikeouts in 18 and a third innings. Former first-round pick Daniel Moskis, aka TheDude41 on Twitter, has a 2.35 ERA and 6 appearances with 5 Ks.
Yeah, well, the dude abides.
In AA Altoona, Starling Marte has been tearing the cover off the ball with a 3.50 average and 900 OPS. Starter Jeff Locke has a 2.3 ERA and 102 whip and is averaging over a K per inning. And the two Aarons, Probanek and Thompson, are a combined 3-3 with a 198 ERA and 0.72 whip in 7 appearances. These high-level pitchers having good starts to the season gives Pirates fans hope that the future of the rotation is much brighter than in years past. The Pirates finished off a wraparound series with the Reds early this week. On Sunday, the Pirates won 7-6. Andrew McCutchen broke out with a 3-for-3 day, including a home run. Chris Reesop got the win. He's been a steady contributor in the Bucks bullpen since he was acquired late last year. On Monday, the Pirates won 9-3 behind Kevin Correia's complete game four-hitter. Every starting Pirates position player had 2 hits except for McCutchen, as the Pirates won 3-4 to secure their third road series win of the year. Let's just say the new Road Warrior Pirates trip to Florida wasn't as sunny as they had hoped. The Pirates were absolutely owned by Josh Johnson in a 6-0 loss on Tuesday. They struck out 12 times and only managed 2 hits. Wednesday was no better as they lost by the same 6-0 score. The Marlins completed a sweep with a 9-5 win on Wednesday. Random guy Scott Cousins hit a grand slam, and equally unheralded Brett Hayes had a 3-run homer to do the damage against James McDonald.
Hayes. I never heard of most of them.
The Pirates once again had a rainout this week as their first game with the Washington Nationals was rescheduled for next Monday. On Saturday, the Pirates won 7-2 thanks in large part to a 5-run first inning. Jeff Carstens, who is once again filling in for the injured Ross Ohlendorf, improved to 2-0 with a strong 6-inning start. Andrew McCutchen stole 2 bases and Jose Tabata stole his 9th base to tie for the National League lead. I'll talk about the other 2 games of the series next week. What do I think about the Pirates this week? Early season inconsistencies in batting and some good pitching have brought the Pirates to a 9-11 record after 20 games. Generally, the Pirates hover around 500 for the first 40 games and then start to decline, so it's up to the pitchers and top part of the batting order to elevate their game even more to buck this trend. Next week, the Pirates will finish out their series with the Nationals, and then they'll start an NL West swing with a home series against the world champion San Francisco Giants and a trip to Colorado to face the Rockies. Well, that about does it for this week. Make sure you join me next week for another edition of This Week in Real Pirate Ball. I'm Greg Mercer. Later.